Now in this video we are going to study grouping of resistors in detail. In the earlier video I told you that grouping of resistors, more than one resistances can be grouped together and they can be replaced by one single resistor which has the same value than which has the same value as that of combination of resistors. So that means there must be some method to combine the resistors. So these we have actually two methods. First method is series combination and another method is parallel combination. So series resistances can be connected in two ways, series combination and parallel combination. So first we are going to study about series combination. What is a series combination? I'll explain with a diagram. Now when there are, suppose we have three resistors R1, R2 and R3 and they are connected like this, one after the other. They are connected like this, they are called in series. Now if you notice carefully that in series, one end of this resistor is connected to battery and the other end is connected to the next resistor. Both the ends of R2 are connected to two different resistors. None of the ends of R2 is connected to battery. End of R3, one end is connected to R2 and another end, the other end is connected to the battery. So when resistors are connected like this, one after the other, then we call it a series combination. They are forming a series, so it is called series combination. Now in series combination, what happens? We have a battery of potential difference V. Let us say a current I is flowing. Now if you look carefully, when current I comes at this point, it has only one path to go. There are no other junctions, there is no other branches of circuit that are coming out, so that means I will not be divided, I will go as it is in this branch. So this means I will enter this branch, the current I will cross R1, then R2 and then R3 and then it will come here. So current I is leaving the battery and it is entering the battery from this side. So this means the current is same in the circuit. Second thing, potential difference. At this point the potential is V, at this point the potential is O. Carried here, potential V, potential O. Now across all these three resistors the potential difference is V and 0 on these two points. But what about on individual resistances? What about just on R1, just on R2 and only on R3? What happens? Does the V and 0 remain same? No. V and 0 is the potential difference between these two points which are in parallel with the battery, these two points. The potential difference here will be different. It will be different and on R3 also the potential difference will be different. Let us say that potential difference here is V1, V2 and V3 such that V1 plus V2 plus V3, what should be it equal to? If we apply common sense, then this, if we assume that there is no loss in this circuit, there is no loss of energy whatsoever, then V1 plus V2 plus V3 should be equal to the potential difference of the battery V. Can this sum be greater than V? Obviously it is not possible because the supply is V. How can the potential difference across different devices can be greater than the potential difference of the source? It can never cross the, it can at the max, it can be equal to the source. So in this class, in the, your syllabus, we are going to take them equal. It can be either equal or less than V, but can never be greater than V. This can never happen. It can be less than V in case there is some loss. But in your syllabus, we are going to assume that there are no losses in the circuit. So V1 plus V2 plus V3 becomes equal to V. So here, what will be the value of V1? If we are asked to find out the values of different potential drops on different resistors, what will be the value? We are going to apply Ohm's law. So according to Ohm's law, V equals to IR. We are going to use same formula. So V1 should be equal to IR1, because I is same for all these three resistors, it is not changing. So V1 equals to IR1. Similarly, V2 equals to IR2. V3 equals to IR3. So we, this way we have the values of different potential drops on R1, R2 and R3, or different potential differences on R1, R2 and R3. Potential drop and potential difference are the same thing. So this means now V1 plus V2 plus V3 equals to V. So that means if I substitute these three values, then IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3 equals to V. I can be taken out as common. So R1 plus R2 plus R3, I can be taken out as common and can be brought on the right hand side. So it will become equal to V by I. From this law again, what is V by I? V by I equals to R. This R is the R equivalent that we talked about. So this will be equal to R equivalent, the one resistor that can replace all these three resistors. So that means from this equation, equivalent resistance will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, and this is your formula for series combination. So if there are three resistors, there are 10 resistors, there are 100 resistors connected in series, the total resistance, the equivalent resistance will be equal to sum of all the resistances. If there are 10 resistances connected, then R equivalent will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 till plus R10. 100, add all of them. So this will be your R equivalent. What does it mean? Now let us use this value. 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm. This means R equivalent for this particular value will be equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. That is 6 ohms. This means that in this circuit, I'll draw it here. This circuit can be redrawn like this. V, I, and this is equal to R equivalent, whose value is 6 ohm. So that means these two circuits are same. R equivalent is the value of R1, R2 and R3 grouped together. So this is your series combination. Remember this formula and remember this diagram, then it is very easy to understand.